The key word when I describe the performance loss in microkernel-based operating system structure is the potential for performance loss. What L3 microkernel does is, by proof of construction, they show that they can debunk the myths about microkernel-based operating system structure. Now, L3 microkernel, being a microkernel, has minimal set of abstractions, has address space, threads, inter-process communication, and a service for providing unique IDs for subsystems that live on top of the microkernel. The exact details of these mechanisms provided by L3 microkernel is not that critical, but the important thing is the microkernel provides the minimal set of abstractions as we've been always talking about, namely address space, threads, inter-process communication, and UID. And L3 argues that these are fundamental abstractions that any subsystem that lives on top of the microkernel or any subsystem that you want to implement in a general purpose operating system requires these facilities, and therefore L3 argues that microkernel should provide this as the minimal set of abstractions. How they actually provide it may differ from one microkernel to the other, but the important takeaway is that this is the minimal set of abstractions that a microkernel should provide. Now let's talk about the system services. Now, as I mentioned in the previous slide, the system services have to be distinct protection domains, protected from one another and protected from the applications that live on top of the operating system. And of course, we have this hard line between the applications and the servers providing these services and the microkernel. This is the structure of a microkernel-based operating system. So what is different about L3 microkernel? The key distinction is that each of these services of the operating system, they have to be in their own protection domain, not necessarily distinct hardware address spaces. The point L3 establishes by proof of construction is that there are ways to construct a microkernel-based operating system, providing these services efficiently, knowing the features of the hardware platform. In other words, L3's argument is it's all about efficient implementation of the microkernel and not the principle of a microkernel-based operating system structure. So to fully understand how L3 microkernel goes about systematically debunking the myths about microkernel-based operating system structure, we have to understand the strikes against the microkernel.